Ang unang topic natin po mapakinggan sa umagang ito is about advance in caving. Ito po ay advance honor. Ito po ay didiscuss na isa sa ating mga pilot training. Kung iba kundi si Master Guide Dante S. Ginalon Jr. So bigay po natin panahon kay Master Guide Ginalon. Sir Dante.
So sa ngayong umaga po ay isa po sa mga owners na i-discuss ko po itong advanced caving. Okay? Let me share to you my screen first. Okay po, sige, let's proceed. So nang tiningnan ko po itong owners po natin, no? May pagkakaiba po ang basic caving at saka yung advanced. So, in my observation, ang ating pong honor for basic caving is like para siyang you're just like a tourist, no? Or nag-visit ka lang sa isang cave and exploring what's inside of it at kung ano mga observations sa loob. But this time, ikaw talaga mismo ang gagawa ng paraan, paplanuhin mo yung tinatawag na caving. And this morning, ang i-discuss ko po ang advanced caving with three important things na i-consider natin to achieve this honor. So number one is geological survey mapping, and then how caves are developed, and then its formation inside, and the last is rappelling, which is a part also of advanced caving requirements. Okay, so let me proceed. Okay. Advanced camping, and one of the most important you have to consider before you do this one is to plan it well, and you should have what? Geological survey maps. Okay, so ano po bang geological survey maps? Actually, nang inaaral ko ito, okay, naalala ko po na during the time sa West Visayan Academy po sa Iloilo, and ang area na lagi naming binibisitahan for caving is yung Guimaras Island, no? Sino po nakapunta sa yung Guimaras Island? So that ang Guimaras Island po ay isa siyang island na napakaraki po siya na napapalibutan ng tubig. So marami pong mga klaseng kuweba po doon ang mapupuntahan. So I remember that we were guided by the local government before going there. But this time, sa requirements po ng advanced caving po, ay ikaw mismo ang gagawa ng mapa mo. So parang ano kay? Parang explorer ka na iisipin mo ang lugar na yan ay hindi mo pa alam, at ang gagawin mo ay you have to map out. When you say map out, may gagawin kang mga survey. I-record mo, no? May measurement po pagdating sa ilang kilometro from the area going to the location of the cave, ilang cave ang nandyan. So, yan po. So, makikita nyo po sa picture po dito is an example of geological survey maps po na kung saan ay there are what you call this one? Identification of the different caves sa isang lugar. Okay? Sa isang lugar po. And with specific siya na drawing as recognized as cave. So, let me read this one, the meaning of a geological map. A geological map or A geologic map or geological map is a special purpose map made to show geological future. Rock units or geologic strata are shown by colors or symbols to indicate where they are exposed at the surface. So, ito pong geological map, mga fellow master guide, is very important. And na when I review this one, most of these are done by mga geodetic engineers, which is they use this one to study the area location with specific identification of the yung tinatawag na mga identification ng klase ng rock formation, positioning of the lands, just like that, no? So napakaano po, napaka broad po. So sa ngayong umaga, re-reviewin lang natin, hindi natin hindi natin pupuntahan yung mga pinaka-detalye talaga ng sa geological maps, but let me know what are the different kinds of geological maps na are used by engineers, surveyors, just like that, explorers, and yan po, aralin natin po, no? Okay. But before that, let me give you a brief history of geological mapping. The map indicating the gold field in Egypt on 30th century is the first recorded attempt in providing graphical geological information. So itataps ko lang dyan, no? In ancient times, Egypt, okay, is using already what this kind of procedure or acts na kung saan ay in development of their area, they're using this what this kind of geological mapping, okay? And the type of geological mapping, may tinatawag ditong reconnaissance map, are made to find out such as possible about geology of an area quickly as possible. So ito pang malakihan talagang ano to, klaseng mapa, and this is created by some persons like engineers for such a special purpose, okay? So tandaan po natin yan, reconnaissance maps, okay? If you see here in the description, they are usually made at scale of 1:250 or smaller, sometimes very much smaller. Ayan po. Okay? Second is regional geological maps should be plotted on reliable base. Unfortunately, in some countries, geological mapping outstrips topographic coverage when there is a sudden economic interest in area, and geologists must then survey the topography themselves. So this is another form of maps as well, no? Na for economic purposes, they are using this one. Now, another thing is detailed geological maps. Scales for detailed geological maps may be anything from 1:10,000 and larger. Such maps are made to investigate specific problems which have arisen during smaller scale mapping or from discoveries measuring mineral exploration, or perhaps for preliminary investigation of the dam site for other engineers project. So isa po ito sa mga ano, isa po ito sa mga way how they detail that kind of what of maps in a certain research, okay? Another thing is specialized maps. Specialized maps are many and various. They included large scale maps or small areas made to record specific geological features in great detail. Some are for research, other for economic purposes, such as open pit mines plans scales from 1:1,000 to 1:2,500 underground geological mine plans. So napakalaki po ito ang gamit po ng ano, ang gamit nito ng tinatawag na special maps. Naalala ko nga, baka ito nga ang ginagamit sa, for example, sa mga minsan, mga treasure hunters or like gold miners, just like that, they use this ones, this special maps talagang to discover some special hard or solid materials object in the ground, okay? So methods of geological mapping, number one is traversing, okay? traversing. I remember this term during the hiking or the mountaineering activity, traversing. So one of the thing that you should do for mapping out is traversing, and it's also used by most of the surveyors, okay, geodetic surveyors. It is also a method of covering the ground in detail required by your employer. A traverse is made by walking more or less predetermined route from one point on map to another. So paggagawa ka ng isang mapa, hindi ka lang tatayo dyan o dyan ka lang sa isang area na para titingnan mo lang kung anong sa paligid, but you have to walk and explore the distance, okay, using some devices for you to map out or to write the details of in making that map. Okay, so next is mapping techniques is traversing, just like what I say, walking along predetermined route, plotting in geology on the way. The geology in between traverse is interpolated using whatever clues can be gleaned from topographic map. So the method is used predominantly for reconnaissance work. So malakihan ito, large areas of ground could be covered. So if you see in the picture, this is the sample po ng isang mapping techniques, and they call it topographic map. So there's so many lines. So kung aaralin mo talaga yan, maintindihan po natin bakit may tinatawag ng mga lines na iba-iba ang position po, no? Okay? So may mga ano yan, may ibig sabihin po yan. And another thing is exposure in green line mapping. Mapping by exposure is the mainstay of much detailed mapping at the scale of 1:10,000 and larger. Ayan. So pangmalakihan siya at malaking area ang covered dito when you do the mapping. So iba dyan, hindi na naglalakad, talagang sasakay sila ng sasakyan. Or some are using helicopters to cover and to get the exact location area using some special devices. Okay? Mapping techniques, okay? Green line mapping. So ito yung sinasabi ko kanina. If you see green line mapping, they try to make a map shading an important region or part of an area. Ibig sabihin yung area niyan is identified as special and they focus on this area as a certain project. Okay, next is boundary mapping. One of the main aims is compiling a geological map, locate a boundary and follow it across the map. One of the easiest method of mapping where exposure is good, very effective in conjunction with aerial photographs, does not work well if exposure is poor. So kung kanina may malakihang mapa na ginagawa, for example, so mapa na yan ay iba't ibang region, pero ito nakafocus po siya sa ano, sa isang area lamang na makikita natin, or you can draw it, you can write it, you can make it as in detail. Ayan. So next is drilling. Okay, bakit may drilling? Iba, when you say drilling, hindi lang surface ng area ang paggawa ng mapa, hindi lang surface ng area ang ginagamit nila. So use like a geodetic surveyor to discover what materials, minerals can be seen below. So kailangan lang mag-drill. So yan pang malakihan yun talaga. Usually mga commercialized mga miners, ginagawa po nila ito. And in that way, they could create a special map identifying not only the area, but of course, the minerals, the kind of rocks, no, na makikita po sa area na yan. So, ayan po. Here in the picture, you can find po mga devices na ginagamit po sa pag-explore ng isang area. Okay? For genetic surveyors, they use, of course, mga hammer and chisels, okay, as part of their detailed study. And for mapping out, okay, ito very useful po sa atin, compass. Ayan. So I know that lots of you are using compass when you do camping, hiking, mountaineering, spelunking, you're using this one. It's very important po and it's very useful na hindi po tayo mawala sa ating pupuntahan at sa ating pabalik. Okay? Next is also the clinometers. Tama po ba ito? Okay, clinometers. So this is a special device. Actually, bira ko nakikita ito eh. This one is the famous one, GPS. Ayan po, GPS. At marami na ngayong mga GPS po na magagamit po natin. Sometimes sa cellphone natin, nandiyan na may mga apps, no? But there's special device talaga or equipment, GPS talaga na which is used indicating an area and use makikita yung numbers doon, yung measurement po ng kada mo, yung pag-traverse mo at paglakad mo po sa isang area po. Okay? And another one is scales. Ayan, pag gumawa ka na ng mapa, kailangan mo ito ng mga klase ng mga ruler na ito to determine the measurement or the figure. Now, you need this one, compass and clinometers, handless tapes, map course, field notebook, acid bottles, global position system, or GPS. So, I wonder why just an acid bottles, siguro ginagamit ito sa mga genetic ito to identify some minerals or content of the rocks or soil, just like that. And next is, ito po mga symbols po na pwedeng gagamitin when you do some mapping. So, naalala ko nung sa Mountain View College, nagtitraining kami ng master guide and one of the requirements is to do mapping. And natatawa kami kasi pag nag-drawing kami, kung ano-anong pinag-drawing namin sa mapa. So, these symbols can help. Pero medyo marami na ito eh. But we can use some symbols basically sa paggawa ng mapa natin for an easy understanding of your companions pag in-apply na po. No? Okay, ito po. Pinapakita ko lang. Marami po yan. So, it will help a lot. Okay. Now, in conclusion about geological mapping is the fundamental task of geologists on the basis of which all subsequent qualitative and quantitative geological studies are carried out leading to understanding of evolution of chosen part of terrain in space and time. The information is present graphically on a chosen scale by use combination of color, characters, lines, and symbols. So, ganyan po ang mapa na gagawin po natin, okay, pag ni-required po tayo. So, here in the picture now, because we're talking about about caving, okay, this is an example of mapping out, okay, survey of a certain cave. So, this is an example only. Makikita po natin dito na kung saan ay after exploring, of course, when you go inside, you need some permission from the local government bago ka mag-explore. Baka mamaya pag-isipan kayo kung ano-ano kayo dyan, no? Baka illegal kayo dyan sa area na yan. And by exploring it, merong tinatawag na mga local expert cavers that you have to contact on it to guide you for your safety as well. So, ito po, makikita nyo ang iba't ibang passage. Okay, dito po sa mapa na ito, makikita nyo yung drawing where there are lots of passages. Makikita nyo rin na para siyang isang maze. So, when you create this one, you will achieve to have at least this kind of map is done in detail. Okay, so going to the drawing of the map that you have done, for example, yung kuweba na napuntahan nyo, exploring the cave, beside of the map that you have done, beside also of the detail of the yung mga passages ng kuweba, you can what? You can imagine now what have you observed inside of it. So ito, for example lang, no? Na makikita mo yung mga ano, mga big rooms, scenic rooms dito sa loob ng ano, ng cave. Okay? So of course, in surveying the area and creating your survey maps, that's include also what observation inside what are any observation you can find inside the cave. So that's it for the part of the geological survey maps. Na bago ka pumunta sa pagkikaving, you have to do this for you to have what? To have a guide, to have an idea bago pumasok po. So let's go to the cave now. Okay. Just like what I've said a while ago, na kung ang difference ng basic caving sa advanced caving, may pagkakaiba po talaga. So this time, when you do advanced caving, you have to not only that nag-visit ka doon para kang isang turista sa loob, but this time, you have to do somewhat research and understand what's going on inside, what are the things, bakit nangyari po itong mga formation sa loob ng ano ng kuweba, paano po ito nagawa. So the question is, paano po, how did these caves form? Okay, but let me read this one here about the cave. A cave is an opening of the ground that is caused by natural geological activities and man. Okay, the sizes and the variety of the rock depends largely on the geographical location. Most caves and caverns refers to limestone, but include sea caves, rock shelters, and grottos, lava tubes. Caverns always have natural light. Caves have zero light. So, ito po ang mga ano? Ito po yung mga observation. Okay, basically, ha, sa isang kuweba po. Na, okay, all cavern always have natural light. Okay, and mostly this observation, you can find it in the entrance of the cave. They have natural light. Okay, and then caves have zero light. Ito sa loob na talaga to. Have zero light. Okay, you can find only light there, some glittering light inside if you're using your flashlight or headlamps as well. And sabi nga dito kanina, a cave is an opening in the ground that is caused by natural geological activities and man. So it could be natural or it could be a result of what? Of human activities. Okay? That is what? That is the formation of a cave. But ngayong umaga, re-reviewin natin, dadaanan natin ang isang importanteng bagay, ang natural formation ng isang ano, ng isang cave. Ayan. So the question is, how do caves form? Okay? So kailangan pag pumunta ka sa isang kuweba, hindi lang talaga gala-gala doon sa loob, but you have to what? You have to go there with a purpose that when you go out from the cave, you have something to share. So how do caves form? Generally, the combination of soluble rock flow, okay, rock flow of water, time contribute the formation of a cave. So rainwater combines with carbon dioxide that creates mild carbonic acid. This carbonic acid flows into cracks of either limestone, okay, which is the most common, chalk, okay, dolomite, marble, salt, and gypsum, which is distress enough to create greater flow of water. After some time, that result is a cave. So there is a participation of the different things here paano nagkaroon ng cave? Paano nagkaroon ng buta sa ilalim ng lupa? Ayan po, dapat yan po ang nating maintindihan. So sabi nga dito, there is a participation of what? Of course, the soluble rock. And what is this soluble rock? Okay? And then the participation of the activity of water. Okay? Activity of water. And then time contribute the formation of a cave. Rainwater combines with carbon. So external and internal participation of materials are what? Are very important in what? In creation of the natural cave na tinatawag. So sabi nga dito, rainwater combines with carbon dioxide that creates mild carbonic acid. Ayan. So kanina tiningnan ko po sa ano, tiningnan ko po sa Google po, there is special what? Special component, no? Yung acid rain, okay? Yung acid rain na ito ay once it drops in the ground, okay? Tandaan po natin, ito pong mga seashells, okay, may mga fossils na for how many or thousands of years na nakabaon na sa lupa, okay, we know there's a flood before, at na ano na yan, yung mga namatay na ng mga, let's say, mga isda, mga clams, mga shells na yan, mga other forms of life na nabaon sa lupa, okay? Once na na-press yan sila, okay? And then, it will result to yung tinatawag na, no, na limestone. Mamaya, madadaanan natin yan, no? It will result to a limestone. And then, once na there's what we call acid rain, tinatawag nila na weak acid, this will what? This, once it reached to the limestone, matutunaw po itong limestone. So let's go with this. Okay. Types of caves. Okay. Nakikita niyo yung chart po dito. Didiretsuhin po natin, ha. Types of different types of caves. Covers, location, information. Limestone caves. Yan ito. Limestone caves, typically what the term caves pertains to because they are most common. So most of the common caves na makikita natin globally, kahit saan tayo pumunta, ang pinaka-common po is limestone caves. Just like what I've said, yung Guimaras Island na yan, halos lime yan eh. Kung pupunta ka doon, kaya ang daming mga caves doon. So, most of the description of the limestone caves are some are long and some are what? Deep. Okay? And found all over the world. The world's most longest cave system is Mammoth Cave in the U.S. state of Kentucky. It is more than 350 miles or 560 kilometers. Ang haba po. Ang layo. Okay? So, paano po ba ito nade-develop limestone na ito? As what I mentioned well ago. Limestone is a sedimentary rock composed largely of mineral, calcite and aragonite. Ayan. Many limestone are composed from shells. Take note of that. And skeletal fragments of marine organisms such as coral or foraminera. Ayan. So ito pala, akala natin, no? Kahit naisip ko rin dati, akala ko yung limestone, talagang bato lang siya. Ito pala, na-form siya dahil sa ano? Sa mga na-decompose na mga like shells, skeletal fragments of marine organism. So siguro yung mga dati, yung mga isda, balihena, sharks, or ano pang mga klaseng animal life na sa tubig, okay? Natambak na siya. At for how many thousand of years, okay? With the participation of the heat and cold temperature, ito po ay ano, tumigas na. Okay. Ayan po. Nabuo na siya. Okay. Next is types of extent formation. Caves have rock structures that looks like a giant icicle called stalactites and stalagmites. Very familiar sa atin yan. Very common yan. And I know that you have studied this one kahit elementary na napag-usapan ito, no? Stalactites and stalagmites. So what is stalactites? Okay, this is only the a short definition of it. Stalactites form on ceiling of caves. So tanda natin, ang stalactites, siya ay ano, nag-exist, lumalabas siya doon sa ceiling. Ceiling, okay? Sa taas. Second is stalagmites form on the ground of the caves. Tataka ka, no? Bakit sa taas may tumutubo, sa baba may tumutubo din. So, the position and the origin of stalagmites form on the ground. Okay, sa galing sa ano, sa baba. Now, how do stalagmites and stalactites grow? Water that has natural minerals floating inside slowly drip from ceiling of caves. Over thousands of years, the minerals slowly harden. So, kung ang tubig continues siya nag-drop, okay, with the participation of different minerals in that particular rocks or area, ay dito po napoform ang tinatawag na, no, na stalactites. Okay? And sabi nga dito, thousands of years, the minerals slowly harden. So, napaka, ano po, napaka amazed, ano, napaka amazing po na ng ganitong ano, ng ganitong pangyayari sa loob ng cave. Next is we have also kanina limestone cave, ah. Tandaan po natin. Ngayon, solution caves. Ano po ang solution caves? These caves are formed by dissolving of the rock along the adjacent to joints, fractures, faults, okay, and layers in the rock. Solution caves are most often found in rock types such as limestone, marble, dolomite, both close relatives of limestone, gypsum, and halite, and are associated with karst landscape. So, napansin ko ito, mga fellow master guide, itong klaseng cave na ito, I've been also in like a cave that are found in malapit sa gubat, no? Malapit sa forest, na kung saan ay you can find this kind of the characteristic ng klase ng ano ng isang ng cave siya. So there are things inside na may common siya doon sa limestone, may pero may difference din siya doon sa ano sa limestone na na klaseng kuweba, okay? And one of kind of stones or rocks na makikita mo dito ay marble and dolomite. Kaya sabi dito, both close relatives of limestone. So same, the common thing you can find, there's stalactites as well on this one and stalagmites on this area. Next is differential erosion cave. Check the picture. May pagkakaiba po pagdating doon sa limestone at saka sa yung sa isa kanyang nabanggit ko. Okay? A cave is typically formed when limestone is dissolved by the flow of weakly acidic water, then redeposited as calcium carbonate, stalactites, and stalagmites risen, horizontal bedding planes of harder iron-rich material were formed within sedimentary lines, limestone, later after layers were uplifted and tilted. The cave was formed in a process called differential erosion. The surrounding limestone dissolved faster than harder materials, leaving these layers exposed as tilted parallel plates. So, as an adventurer, okay, as an explorer inside the cave before, very exciting po nakakita ka ng ano ng stalagmites at saka stalactites, and then nagiglitters pa yan minsan yung wall ng ano ng cave, no? But this kind of cave, differential erosion cave, nabanggit dito na there is what we call acidic water that what once it touched with stalagmites and stalactites, ito yung resulta siya pang pinutunaw niya hanggang ano magdi-deform siya instead na matulis siya pahaba, ito para siyang mga ano, parang siyang pancake na ano nakataklap-taklap, no? So ganun po. Next is we have mechanical erosion cave. Mechanical erosion cave. So erosional caves are caves which form entirely by erosion, typically by flowing water, removing rocks and other sediments. As a result, the chemical properties of the rock are irrelevant and such caves can form inside any type of rock. Important are the mechanical properties like hardness, cleavability, or fissibility. Facility. Initially, they need some zone of weakness to allow water to enter the rock, such as fault or joint. See the picture here of mechanical erosion cave. May pagkakaiba doon sa nabanggit ko kanina. Okay? And sabi nga dito, erosional caves are caves which form entirely by erosion. And it water is what involved on this what? On this kind of what? Development of the cave. So, para siyang mga maninipis na mga ano na mga parang shells siya, no, na malalapad na tinataklap-taklap din. So, ito nga din ang kanyang ano, ang kanyang pagkakaiba. Okay? And there is what we call a type of rock on this what? On this formation. Next is underwater cave. Okay? Have you experienced underwater cave? Ako hindi pa ako na-experience, okay? Underwater caves can be found around the world, and I try also to watch YouTube. There are lots of people do this adventure. They try to nag-adventure sila about this underwater caves, at very exciting. But of course, there are still caves. Ang pagkakaiba lang, talagang natatakpan ito ng tubig. And some of these caves are, sa entrance pa lang, tubig na siya. So, bababa sila. Ang iba naman, doon mismo saan? Sa ilalim na. From dry area part of the cave, going to the bottom, may mga area na kung may tubig siya. Okay? Sabi dito, underwater caves can be found around the world, but appears and develop differently according to their environment. Caves in warmer water can be home to coral reefs. So ito ang isang ecosystem ng isang cave na kung saan coral reefs is comfortable with warmer water inside of it. While ice caves have less abundant life. Mamaya dadaanan natin niya yung glacier and ice caves. Photographers and divers have made it possible for us to get a glimpse of these mysterious underwater worlds. Alam mo, minsan nakakatakot nga ng no kung yung sa ilalim ka ng tubig. How much more pa pag dito ka sa ilalim ng tubig pero nasa ilalim ng isang ano, ng isang ground or isang cave. Ayan. So another thing is sandstone caves and mud caves. Ang sandstone caves form from water and wind action found inland. This is Mormon rocks in Cajun Pass, California. So, I think nakaka-observe din tayo ng ganitong klaseng mga bato na malalaki na may mga butas-butas. Okay? Sandstone caves. Dito sa Saudi Arabia, northern part of Saudi Arabia and southern part, okay, near Jordan and near Mount Sinai, makikita mo itong klaseng mga bato na ito. And usually, the government is using right now as a tourist spot itong mga area na to. Okay? This kind of formation ng cave na ito is due to what? To wind. Okay? The blast of the wind. So, yan po. Now, another thing is mud caves. Mud caves formed by water flowing through deposit of what? Slit. Popular in Anza, Borrego, Desert State Park in San Diego County, California. So, marami pong ano, itong dalawang klase na itong cave na ito ay they are not very big. Okay? Hindi sila malalim, hindi rin mahaba. Kunti lang talaga yan kasi nga the formation of this is not like involved with the involvement of the water. Ito puro ano, hangin. Okay? And the mud caves, sabi dito nga, is through participation of what? Of the water, pero hindi siya kagaya ng ano ng mga malakihang cave, no. Next is Illulian cave. Illulian caves are shallow caves formed when wind blasts. Oh, so yun, para siyang ano din kanina, para din siyang sand cave, no. Blast silt fine sand against a rock face. These types of caves are rarely longer than a few tens of meters. So ibig sabihin, maiksi lang talaga siya. Okay? Another thing is sea caves. Ayan. Sea caves, also known as littoral cave, is a type of cave formed primarily by the wave action of the sea. Alam ko, mahilig kayong pupunta sa dagat and then mag-explore sa mga gilid ng isang island. Oh, 100 islands natin. Pupunta kayo sa Palawan, sa Mindoro. Okay? You can find this kind of what? Of this formation. Nabubuta siya dahil sa ano? Sa tubig. And this water is what? Is involved on the natural formation of this kind of cave. Sea caves. Okay? Next is, okay. Sabi nga dito, caused by waves crashing against sea cliffs causing erosion located near coast. Okay. So, yan lang po. Another thing is glacier caves or ice cave. Yan, ito na po yung sinasabi ko kanina. Form entirely of ice from a glacier. From a glacier. Okay? So, isa siyang cave, pero hindi siya covered ng rock or naturally formed na galing sa mga bato. Ito talagang ice siya. Ito naman yung ice cave, any cave that has ice throughout the year, anywhere below freezing. So ito naman ay naka-attach siya sa mga bato, sa mismo sa ano, sa mga rocks. And there is already some holes na kung saan during winter ito po ano, nabubuo siya na classic cave, and many of the explorers are doing to enter in this area. Okay, another thing is, okay, yung light dadana natin yan kanina, Talus Cave. Ito, have you heard this one? Talus cave are what? Sabi dito, are openings formed between boulders piled up on mountain slope. So most of them are very small, both in length and cross section. Some boulder piles, however, do have explorable interconnected passages of considerable length. So ito siya para mga ano, hindi siya kagaya ng mga caves na naturally participated by water, by acid water, no? And then with some minerals na na-form talaga siya ng nabutas. Ito, iba. Mga bato na malalaki, siguro dahil sa lindol, malaking bato, nag-piled up, nagtambak-tambak, and nag-create siya ng, ano, ng isang mga passages sa loob na some people are exploring this. No? Mahilig sila pumasok sa mga butas-butas. Next is sinkhole and talus. Oh, nabanggit rin yung talus dito. Sinkholes happen when the roof of a cave collapses, usually caused by human activity. So, narinig yun, daming sinkhole. I think sa Pilipinas, meron na rin mga sinkhole, no? So, pag may mga tinatawag na ano, na mining, okay? Yan ay isa din sa mga ano, nagresulta ng sinkhole. Yung mga cost nito. Yun nga, isa, mining, and then meron ding tinatawag na yung daan, yung sa ilalim niyan, may mga tinatawag na water activity na kung saan ay minsan bigla na lang nabubutas siya dahil sa ano, sa human activity on that area. Ganyan. Okay? Next is lava tube cave. Ang dami palang cave, no? Lava tube cave. Ito naman, a lava cave is any cave formed in volcanic rock through it typically means caves formed by volcanic processes which are more properly termed volcanic caves. So, ito ay also explored by some people na kung saan ay nangyayari ito at nakikita na ito after what? Volcanic activity. So, kung titingnan mo ang walls dito ng cave, hindi siya, no? Hindi mo makikita yung stalactites, stalagmites, okay? And other formation. But you can see the traces of the lava. Ayan. Another thing, okay, let's proceed it. Okay, so what other things or what special things you can find inside the cave? Okay, let me touch this one, fossils presence, okay? Fossils found in our limestone layers reflect the environment at that time and include the typical Mississippian period sea creatures like corals, crinoids, brachiopods, gastropods, and sharks. So let me touch a little bit. Ito po mga fossils, itong binabanggit ko, na kagaya nga kanina, one for how many years, na pag wala na silang buhay, matambakan sila, matambakan hanggang titigas. Ayan. And with the participation of the acidic water, matutunaw sila. And yan, nagiging ano na, wala na sila, flush out na sila doon sa loob ng isang hole at nagkaroon ng ano, ng malalaking butas sa loob doon. So, these fossils are what? Like corals, number one yan, very common yan, crinoids, brachiopods, ito yung mga life forms inside na, na mga animal form, no? Na kaganya ng mga shells, yung mga clams, brachiopods, gastropods, yung mga animals na kung saan gamit na yung tiyan nila sa paglalakad nila, okay? And sharks as well, okay? Now, next is life forms in nature sa loob ng cave. Ito po, in dark spaces are sheltered from weather and provide steadily temperature making them ideal homes. Ito po yung ano? Ito po yung mga bats. Ayan, isa po yan na common makikita natin na mga may mga cave po na maraming mga bats. Okay? So other thing we can find also is what? Ito po, sa picture makikita po natin may mga spiders, may mga snakes, and other things. So sa kuweba na napuntahan ko sa Iloilo, may isang cave talaga. Actually, area na yan, marami siyang mga cave. May isang cave na bawal papasukan. Kasi ang cave na daw yun ay ang daming mga ahas, no? Ang daming ahas, bawal talaga. In the entrance lang makikita mo yung mga poisonous na, no, na klaseng mga ahas na ang kulay black, red, just like that. And then you can find also some spiders. So that's part of the what of the observation and exploration in a certain cave. Okay? Next is there are kinds of what Ankalian. Okay, this refers to coastal caves formed in limestone or volcanic rock that are flooded with sea water. So sa loob nito, mga fellow master guide, you can find some kind of these species. Usually, halos dito sa kanila ay mga bulag. Kasi they are what? They are comfortable doon at nabubuhay sila, nakaka-adapt sila sa madilim na area. Okay, so napakarami po yan. And sa entrance po ng cave, makikita din po natin ang tinatawag na ano, na mga pananim. Merong mga lumot, ayan, other types of plants na makikita. Why these things are not cannot be seen inside the cave? Because these things are not exposed by under the sun. Pero ito, they are what? They're exposed to the rays of what? To the sunlight. Kaya nag-grow sila dito sa ano, dito sa entrance. Okay? And okay, balik po tayo. Okay, so tapos na po tayo doon. Now, let me go the last one with the cave rappelling. Okay? Ang cave rappelling po mga kapatid, this is part of the requirements sa advanced caving. Hindi lang walking, crawling, hiking inside the cave, but there are types of caves na kung saan hindi lang siya flat na maglalakad ka lang doon. Hindi lang siya kunting slope, mayroong talagang ibang na para siyang ano, yung dadaanan mo, you have to do some rappelling. So let me give you some basic ideas on rappelling. Okay. Sabi nga dito, cave rappelling is directly linked to caving. So hindi lang pala ano, no, hindi lang pala caving ang isa sa mga activity na gagawin natin doon, but rappelling is involved on this para ma-explore pa natin ang mga malalim na part ng cave. So, before you do this, of course, before going inside, what you need is to have a complete rappelling devices. Ang may mga papangalan niya, you have your helmet, your shoes, your ropes, your ATC devices. In ATC devices, very important on rappelling, and they call it air traffic control. ATC, air traffic control. Yun po yung ginagamit mo sa pag-rappel. And then you have the carabiner. Yan, makikita mo yan. Ibang klaseng color. Okay? And sabi dito, dito po, review natin konti. So in rappelling, you have to consider this one, safety review, rappel commands, mantar hinge, rescue aid, pass the knot, and change over. So knot tying is application of this is applied to this, okay? Rappelling, safety backups and safety check, tie a double overhand or figure eight knot in the end of your rope to prevent rappelling of the end. So babilisan ko po ito kasi oras natin maiksi. You see now, yung knot tying dito is involved. Eight knot at the end of your rope. Mamaya papakita ko sa inyo dito. Apply weight to anchors and rappelling equipment slowly. Okay? Bounding rappels are prohibited. Only walk-down rappels are to be used. So, usually, rappelling, pababa lahat ang application nito. Okay? Using some rappelling devices. Now, in the picture here, rope management, tie a knot in the opposite end to prevent rappelling of the end of the rope. Anong purpose nito ng bakit may 8 knot dito? Hmm? This is used for what? To control or a part of your safety using those special device for this to hold. Okay? Next is edge transition. Have your anchor checked by the safety. Okay? Have your safety checked. Weight your anchor before you reach the safety line. Begin with your feet shoulder apart. Look for the footholds before you transition the edge. Check for the edge pro that may be needed. Okay? So, bago mo gagawin yan, of course, you have to wear your safety harness. Ang safety harness po, mga kapatid, dito po sa waist po natin, ilalagay. And those safety harness have different parts which you have to place all your rappelling devices, okay? So there are also commands on rappelling, okay? At the top, on belay, belay on rappel, rappel on. So gagamitin mo itong mga command when you going down, okay? At the ground, pagdating mo sa baba, okay? Yung at the top, ibig sabihin, mula sa taas, pababa ka pa lang, going down, ito yung mga command na gagamitin mo. But pag nasa ground ka na, off rappel, off belay, okay, or belay off. So ito, this is a command or communication with the support people sa baba, okay, or sa taas. Next is, we have the rappelling devices, para may idea po kayo. This is what we call the ATC devices or air traffic control. Itong orange na ito, ito po yung carabiner mo. So this is connected on your safety harness. Okay, so nakikita nyo dyan, okay, rappel devices, rescue aid with ears. So, yan, dadaanan na po natin to para may idea kayo. Rigging the rescue aid. Ayan, this is how they use what? They use this this device using the rope. Mapapansin nyo po, sa right side, ang isa pataas, ang isa pababa. Kasi ang purpose nyan, that will help you to what? That will help you to release ang dito po sa brake, yung may kamay po dyan. Okay? That is your breaker. So once, dapat laging nakaano yan, using your right hand, laging nakahawak yung kamay mo dyan para hindi ka agad-agad bumaba ng mabilisan. Okay? Your left hand is on the other side, itong sa taas na rope. Hawakan mo to yan. Habang ikaw ay pababa. Okay? Mamaya pakita ko yung mga pictures. So, rescue aid friction method, single wrap and double wrap. So, may single wrap but may double wrap wrap din. Pero, both of them are safety. Okay? They are safety pagdating sa, ano, sa rappelling. So, ang double wrap, parang ang dating, naninigurado ka eh, no? Na hindi ka talaga ma-disgrace siya. Okay? Another thing is rescue aid friction. Ayan po. Minimum and maximum. Okay? Maganda yan pag in-apply natin in actual. How to avoid dropping rescue? Okay? Ito po yung mga method how to put your rope on that device. Okay? Tie off the rescue aid. Okay? Yan po. Makikita po natin. So maganda sana mag-ano tayo, mag-demo ng ganyan. Eh, no? And another thing is rappel devices. Mantar hinge. So, ikita mo dito ang iba't ibang kasing carabiner nito, orange, the gold one and the blue one, ayan po. So, at sa baba niya, ito po yung correct ha. Kita yung correct, yan po ang tama. Napansin yung difference doon sa incorrect. Ma-disgrasya po tayo niyan kapag iyon ang position po ng rope. Ayan, okay? Next is munch hinge. Ito po din po. Okay? Yan, nakikita nyo na ngayon ha. Brake must be opposite the gate. Okay, ito yung breaker mo. Laging ang hawak niyan, right hand lagi yan. Nasa baba, sa waist part o right part ng iyong katawan to control the flow of what? Of the rope. Okay? We have also the tie-off. Tie-off. Okay. We use this one using half hitch and overhand. So, ang purpose nito, okay, ito po, ayun o, ginagamit po ito ang half hitch and overhand kapag ano, kapag you want to, what do you call this one? Sample na sa middle of the rappelling ka. Magpahinga ka muna. So, you can use this one to for your safety. Okay. Another thing is safety backups and safety check. Ayan. Safety backups and safety check. So, self belay, active, independent belay. Tingnan niyo yung picture. May pagkakaiba. Bakit may green dito sa active, independent belay? So, sa mga baguhan na rappelling na nagra-rappel po mga fellow master guide, kailangan yan. Yung green na rope na ito. Anyway, this is a color. But this rope is very important. Kasi pag hindi ka expert, you have to have that one para kung in case ano man ang mangyari sa'yo. For example, you don't know yet how to use these ATC devices, how to break, how to feed yung pagbaba mo using to feed the speed of this rope, ay kailangan mo din tinatawag na active independent belay procedure. So may nakaano yan, may tali sa taas doon na for your safety. So ang self belay wala. So usually expert are doing this one. So kasi alam na nila yan eh kung anong gagawin. And sa mga trainee, mapansin mo nandun yung tinatawag na active independent belay kanina yung green. Pero sa ano naman, sa rescue, support and rescue, dalawa participated by the new participant o baguhan pa lang sa rappelling at the same time yung expert nandiyan na. Okay? So, ito mga samples lang po ito how to do the rappelling. Okay? So, makikita po natin that all important ropes, all the important devices are attached in the body. Tataka ka, bakit? Ano yun? Ang daming mga tali, no? Okay. Puntahan natin ito konti. Malapit na po. Ascending equipment. Ascending. Ano po bang ascending equipment naman? Kaninang descending, pababa. Ang ascending, pataas. If you can see in the picture, there is what we call micro sender. Ang micro sender is like a special device na you're going to use this one. Alam niyo yung ano, yung mga tumatak, umaakyat sa poste, yung mga electrician, mag-aayos. Meron silang ano, 'di ba sa paa nila, meron silang sapatos na may parang may sharp thing na kung saan to hold them. So ito naman sa kamay, meron silang parang holder na kada akyat ilalak mo 'yan. And then the second device, the second micro sender, sa dalawa yan eh, left and the right hand, you're going to use that one. Okay, so para kang nag-aakyat sa isang poste pag ganun, no, paakyat using right ascender. Yeah, may term dito, right ascender. So cowstail, ito ang ano, ang dinadaanan ng right ascender at saka left ascender. Okay, so next is yan po, yung sinasabi ko kanina, left ascender, cowstail, left steer up. Now left steer up and safety line, left ascender, Ito po yung ano, yung rope na kung saan yung paa mo, dalawang paa mo nandyan. Okay? Pag may demo tayo, maganda yan. Kasi ang left ascender mo is connected there saan? Doon sa left steerer mo. Ang right steerer mo is connected so doon sa ano, sa may right ascender mo, okay, na device. So, okay, let's pass on this. Okay. Okay, so these are the pictures of a sample of rappelling na kung saan this is the right position when you do the rappelling, especially when you go, when you descend, papababa. Okay? Left hand is always on what? On the rope, on the top rope. Ang right hand mo laging nasa baba, which is breaker yan. Okay? Nasa katawan niya yung ano ha, yung safety harness and then the ATC device, yung kaninang binabanggit ko. Ang right hand mo laging nakaposisyon yan. Huwag mo dapat yung bitawan kasi pag once bitawan mo, kasi yan, ang right hand mo nakahawak yan sa baba, that is your breaker. Kung sasakyan pa, ha, yun yung ano mo, yung preno mo. Okay? And your left hand is your control or anchor na unti-unti mong i-release yan kapag ano, kapag na-fed na ito ng breaker mo dito. Okay? Next is, when you do rappelling, the right also position is what? Is to place your foot in the wall. Okay? Hindi yung mukha mo o katawan mo o likod mo gagamitin mo doon sa wall. Magagasgas yan. So, kailangan pa ang gamitin mo. Okay? And last is, when you do rappelling, hindi lang dapat na dire-diretso ka pababa para makauwi ka na. Kailangan titingnan mo rin ang paligid mo kung ikaw ay safe or not. Kasi mamaya may mga bato, may mga kahoy na baka matusok ka o mabagok ka. Okay? So that's it. So the requirements for the advanced cabing to achieve this one is you need to what? To log 100 hours of cabing experience. Keep accurate records of each cabing trip. Okay? If you have time, you can do this one in your club. Okay? If you are required, ang kailangan dito according sa manual is you have to log 100 hours of cabing experience. Okay? So, okay. How, what are the solutions for us to save the caves, mga kapatid or mga fellow master guide? The term conservation, sabi dito, may iba't ibang meaning siya, no? Okay? But the bottom line of this, this is the slogan for that conservation. Remember, take nothing but photographs, leave nothing but footprints. So I hope that in the simple presentation that I have, may nakuha po kayong lesson dito about sa geographical mapping survey. You have to map it out. Second, the development and the progress of how the caves are formed. Okay, and next is the basic rappelling, which is connected on the exploration of the cave. So thank you and God bless us all.